Come on, that's the face of someone who's clearly demon-possessed.
The nerds, not net.
Tool drummer Danny Carey believes that he can summon demons to do his will by practicing ritual magic through trance-like drum patterns. Danny Carey wrote the foreword to a 2009 book titled The Wickedest Books in the World, Confessions of an Aleister Crowley Bibliophile.
Bruh.
This volume is a collection of writings of the British wizard, occultist, and inventor of magic, Aleister Crowley. Symbols of Crowley's Golden Dawn cult and other Masonic imagery feature on Danny's website. Danny also sells a t-shirt of a Crowley quote. This bio was listed on the official Tool website at one time, but was removed. Web Archive still allows users to see the old site. An element of mystery was added to Danny's childhood when one day he spied his father with a large sword conducting a Masonic ritual. Despite not becoming a Mason or aligning himself with any other school of religion, Danny has maintained his heritage's interest in occult studies. Some Tool fans have argued that this is simply a joke and a bit of edgy marketing to emphasize the mystique and darkness of the Tool brand. This type of thinking would be reasonable if it were not for the band's frequent references to occult ideas, symbols, imagery, and writers.
Really, what science was discovering was that psychedelics induce a mystical experience, you know, a kind of union with the divine, infinite intelligence of the cosmos and things. And anybody who's taken acid knows what we're talking about. And my painting, The Net of Being, which was on Tool's last album, was something that was born right out of one of those ayahuasca experiences.
Danny himself has also confirmed this fact about his father in a 2019 interview. I think it was my dad. He was a master Mason and all this stuff. So he was always into the Freemasonic writings. We always had it around the house. I was always fascinated with it. I was attracted to it. So I just went for it. He didn't do anything to hide it from me by any means. He helped push me that way, which I'm really indebted for. Danny's old bio continues with this disturbing description. Danny then set up his drums into proportions utilizing the circle and square of the New Jerusalem and uttered a short prayer relating to the principles of the Ace of Swords from the Book of Thoth. He then performed a ritual utilizing his newfound knowledge of the Unicursal Hexagram to generate a pattern of movement in space relating to Fuller's Vector Equilibrium Model. The resulting rhythm and gateway summoned a demon. He was contained within the lodge that has been delivering short parables similar to passages within the Book of Lies. The Unicursal Hexagram was the symbol of Crowley's Golden Dawn Order. Danny's drum skins feature such occultic symbols and patterns. In a 2001 Pulse magazine interview, Danny describes the Tool recording studio in this manner. A huge geometric grid covers the ceiling, which is also decorated with gargoyles and skulls. Two 100-year-old swords, once used by Carey's father in Masonic rites, adorn a wall, with more geometric patterns, a mace, an occultic library, with umpteen first edition Aleister Crowley books, an enormous Enochian magic board, inscribed with the names of various angels and used to channel spirits, is lodged behind Carey's drums. Enochian is a demonic language that was promoted by Walt's occultist John Dee and an automatic writer called Edward Kelly. Here is an example of Danny drumming behind a magic board. Danny describes the recording process with his magic board in a 2001 interview with Modern Drummer. We try to take advantage of every tool available. We'll do whatever it takes to get the best recording we can to get us into the optimum position to make music. Danny believes his board is evocative and serves a purpose in Tool's production process. Danny describes the process of channeling demons while drumming. Every number has its strike on the subconscious in one way or another. The more you can make yourself sensitive to these things, the more it can open you up to other forces that may want to be heard. It's my job to get my ego out of the way enough to be sensitive to these things and let them flow through me. I've always been fascinated with sacred geometry. Those are some of the shapes I've drawn on the Simmons pads. It's about tracing the manifestation of matter into the physical world. Danny describes that his drumming is a tool to connect the listeners with demons. When people come to see us, I want to make it as much of a ritualistic experience as possible. Some beats suck people in. The ritual Danny is speaking of here is an Aleister Crowley-inspired routine to summon demons. According to the Bible, occultic forces are real and legitimate. The Egyptian magicians Janus and Jambres, who resisted Moses, were able to replicate three different miracles. The prophets of Baal shed blood, as did Crowley in his rituals, when resisting Elijah, and were surprised and confused when their invocations were not answered. The man possessed by demons known as Legion had supernatural strength and could not be bound with chains. The demon-possessed slave girl and axe made her masters much profit from being able to tell future events. It is no surprise then that Tool's 2019 album, titled Fear Inoculum, was preceded by a worldwide fear of COVID-19 that has been used by governments to justify forced lockdowns. The lyrics of the song specifically reference a being called the Deceiver, advising the listener to fear the breath. Deceiver says, he says, you belong to me. You don't want to bring the light of the others. Fear the light, fear the breath, fear the others for eternity. Something ain't right! Danny, in a 2020 interview, stated that he was looking forward to a universal vaccine or inoculum to combat COVID-19.
Just hope that some vaccine or something comes up.
God, I know. I think the vaccine will do it.
Vaccination DNA. Vaccine created by the CIA.
One fascinating feature of demons who encounter Jesus in the Gospels is that they are always terrified of Christ and plead for mercy. The demons know their end, a lake of fire. Knowing this, they tremble. And so should all who align themselves with seducing spirits and doctrines of demons. According to the scriptures, all who are truly born again are dwelt with the Spirit. This is the Spirit of God who animates the Christian to do good works and worship God in a way that is pleasing to him. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to check out theonerds.net for more.
When I was in trouble, my way was as dark as night. Jesus gave me comfort and brought me to the light. He took away my sorrow and made my burdens light.